ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट रेस्पेक्टेड श्री रवि शर्मा जी, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर टिस एंड ऑल्सो द डायरेक्टर IIM मुंबई प्रोफेसर मनोज कुमार तिवारी जी, प्रो वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर शंकर दास जी, ऑफिस सिटिंग रजिस्ट्रार श्री नरेंद्र मिश्रा जी, ऑल दी ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ द एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल, एकेडमिक काउंसिल, डीन्स, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड स्टाफ मेंबर्स, एस्टीम्ड गेस्ट्स, मीडिया पर्सन्स एंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली दी ग्रेजुएटिंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ दिस पायनियरिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड देयर प्राउड पेरेंट्स. It is with great pride and gratitude that I address you today as the Chancellor of this distinguished institution, the Tata Institute of Social Sciences. On this significant convocation day, I want to extend my sincere congratulations to our students as they step into the next chapter of their lives. We must also recognize the steadfast support and sacrifices made by their parents and teachers who have played most significant role in this journey. Dear students, today is a day you will always remember. After all, it is a landmark day, a milestone. I know your journey has not been easy. Remember, if the mountain were not steep and the climb did not test your determination, the view would not be much such a magnificent revelation. Now you have scaled the mountain peak and new possibilities stretch out before you. It is a new beginning of your professional life and a time to look forward to the impact you will create on society. Our former President of India, Bharat Ratna, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam once said, "If you want to shine like a sun, you must first burn like a sun. Let hard work and focus keep you on your toes for your future endeavor, and may you all contribute for the nation building according to your ability, potential and skill to raise the prestige of your family, institution and the country at the global level. I have no doubt that you will be the change you want to see in the world and positively impact thousands of lives. As I look out at this audience of intelligent and passionate individuals, I am reminded of the institution's rich and profound philosophical legacy and its contribution to shaping a more just, equitable, and compassionate society. TIS is known for its contributions in the field of social sciences and social work. Dear students, since you are graduating from this institute, your responsibility has now increased and you have to prove yourselves worthy of this accreditation. Convocation ceremonies are not merely a celebration of academic achievement. They also represent a rite of passage, an opportunity to reflect on the past, engage with the present, and chart the course of the future. Since its inception in 1936, TIS has stood as a beacon of excellence in social science, education, and research. Founded with a vision to address the critical needs of Indian society, TIS has consistently upheld the values of social justice, inclusivity, and empowerment. Over the decades, the TIS has produced leaders, scholars, and change makers who have dedicated their lives to solving the pressing challenges of our times. I am proud to say that our institution is engaged in research which is locally need-based, socially relevant, nationally important, and globally significant. Having served as an academic and educational administration for a long time, I can confidently state that our institution has a moral and ethical obligation to serve and contribute to society. Conducting socially relevant research ensures that academic efforts are not only theoretical but also practical. It tackles the pressing social issues such as inequality, healthcare, education, environmental challenges, and sustainability. This aligns the university's mission with the broader goals of societal progress and justice. By solving local problems, universities can improve the quality of life for the surrounding population, fostering a sense of trust, support, and mutual benefit between the institution and the community. This also creates opportunities for applied research that can directly impact people's lives. My friends, this is how the higher education institutions in our country can act as catalysts for social transformation. Dear friends, the idea of Vasudeva Kutumbakam is deeply rooted in India's philosophical and spiritual traditions, which have promoted global harmony and collective well-being. Vasudeva Kutumbakam also encourages our higher education institutions to engage in social and community services by promoting the idea that the world is one interconnected family. I can proudly state that we are deeply committed to social responsibility, enriching our educational impact, and contributing to the creation of a more connected and compassionate world. Ratan Tataji once wisely said, "Never undermine the power of kindness, empathy, and compassion in your interactions with others." These values not only define our character but also shape the impact we have on those around us. Let us lead with kindness and empathy, knowing that these qualities can inspire change and foster stronger, more meaningful relationships. India's ancient wisdom offers enduring solutions in today's complex world, where rapid technological advancements and globalization have created new challenges. However, as a society, we must ensure that these knowledge systems are not relegated to history books. Institutions like this are at the forefront of integrating these ancient insights into contemporary research and problem solving. Your role as graduates will be to engage critically with this knowledge, ensuring that it remains relevant and continues to serve the needs of humanity in this rapidly changing world. As all of you are aware, that on 29th July 2020, the first education policy of the 21st century, that is National Education Policy of India, NEP 2020, was rolled out after a gap of 34 years. I had the privilege of having engaged at the formulation and implementation of the National Education Policy as the chairman of the University Grants Commission. The vision of the policy is to instill among the learners a deep-rooted pride in being Indian, not only in thought but also in spirit, intellect, and deeds, as well as to develop knowledge, skills, values, and dispositions that support responsible commitment to human rights, sustainable development and living, and global well-being, thereby reflecting a truly global citizen. NEP 2020 will ensure that education touches the life of each and every citizen, considering their needs and necessities, besides creating a just and equitable society. For this, an approach to creating a new system aligned with the aspirational goals of emerging time education, while remaining consistent with India's value systems and ethos, has been followed. The NEP places major emphasis on holistic multidisciplinary education as a fundamental component. An effort has also been made to bring in professional and vocational education into mainstream education. The NEP 2020 gives an integrated yet flexible approach to education. The policy recommends strengthening research in the university system. It also envisages multiple entry and exit systems, along with the academic bank of credits, to pave the way for seamless transition between employment and education, while also addressing the socio-economic circumstances of the students. The policy envisages a light but tight mechanism for regulation, providing a more cohesive edifice for the higher education institutions for teaching and research, ensuring enhanced autonomy and empowered governance and effective leadership. The policy aims at the development of skill sets for students while providing enough flexibility in making choices consistent with the dynamics of the knowledge society. Friends, the world is looking to India for solutions to some of our most pressing challenges related to climate change, poverty alleviation, peace building, etc. The values of tolerance, empathy, and mutual respect, which are deeply ingrained in our philosophical traditions, will be critical as we engage with an increasingly fragmented and polarized global order. As you step into your careers as professionals in various fields, whether it is a social work, public policy, health, or education, remember that you carry the responsibility of shaping not just your own future, but the future of this great nation. As TISS graduates, you are uniquely positioned to make a difference. TISS has a long-standing reputation for producing socially conscious leaders who have gone on to contribute significantly to nation building. This institution has equipped you with knowledge and a sense of responsibility to contribute to the betterment of society. In a world where inequality, environmental degradation, and conflict seem ever present, the solutions lie in the values of justice, equity, and compassion, which have been central to India's ancient traditions and this academic ethos. I urge you all to dream big, to embrace challenges, and to never lose sight of the ideals that brought you to this institution in the first place. Be bold in your actions, but always stay grounded in the principles of ethics and empathy that form the core of Indian philosophy. As we reflect on our goals and the path ahead, I am again reminded of the words of Ratan Tata, who said, the true measure of success is not just in what you achieve, but also in how you impact others positively. This statement holds deep significance, especially for us. Success is not merely about personal milestones. It is about the positive changes we bring to our communities, the lives we uplift, and the legacy we leave behind. In conclusion, I congratulate you once again, the TISS graduates of 2024, on your diligence and accomplishments. As you enter the world, remember the rich legacy you carry within you, the legacy of a nation and this institution that has always valued knowledge, wisdom, and service to humanity. You are the torch bearers of this legacy, and the future of this country and the world lies in your hands. In the words of Rabindranath Tagore, the highest education is that which does not merely give us information, but makes our life इन हार्मनी विद दी एग्जिस्टेंस। इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ कुलाधिपति के रूप में मैं आप सभी विद्यार्थियों को अपनी शुभकामनाएं देता हूं, आशीर्वाद देता हूं, और आपके सपने हों वो साकार हों, आपके संकल्प पूरे हों। लेकिन कुछ चीज़ें मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा कि हमेशा अपनी ऊंचाइयाँ छुए हैं, ऊंचे उड़े हैं, लेकिन ज़मीन को न छोड़ें, अपनी रूट्स को, अपने कल्चरल हेरिटेज को, अपने परवरिश को न भूलें। जिन माता पिता ने आपको यहाँ तक पहुँचाया है, उंगली पकड़ करके आपको चलना सिखाया है, उनका हमेशा सम्मान करें, अपने गुरुओं का आदर करें। जिस संस्था से आप विदा हो रहे हैं उस संस्था का हमेशा याद रखें, इसके लिए एलुमनाई के रूप में हमेशा कंट्रीब्यूट करें, और जिस मातृभूमि में आपने जन्म लिया है उसको ऋण को चुकाने के लिए हमेशा तत्पर रहें। आपकी जीवन यात्रा सफल हो, मंगलमय हो, आपको शुभकामनाएं, धन्यवाद, जय हिंद।